Thousands of employees walked out of Google offices in more than 40 locations around the world today, protesting the company's handling of sexual misconduct claims.
Nearly 17,000 workers in at least 40 offices all over the world protested yesterday.
A protest or the walk off the job is the mishandling of sexual misconduct allegations against the executives of Google.
The New York Times investigation last week showed how Google paid millions of dollars in exit packages to Andy Rubin and other male executives accused of misconduct.
We demand structural change in the name of transparency, accountability, and equity.
So Beth, let's talk a little bit about what's happening at Google right now.
So Google is going through a really interesting cultural moment. There is an unprecedented level of workplace activism happening there. So you're seeing employees who are pretty senior, been there for a really long time, are starting to question management's business decisions in a really public way. So Google's always had that culture of debate, but it's kind of been internal, and now I think it's really bursting out into the public.
And how is management responding?
So I think management is trying to walk a fine line here. So, you know, a couple of things that we've seen, which the most public of which was the Google walkout, which happened in November. 20,000 Google employees all over the globe took to the street to protest the company's handling of sexual harassment. And that's a lot of people. I mean, Google has 100,000 employees, full-timers, and 20,000 of them took to the street.
That's a lot of people to organize.
It's a lot of people. And I think this may have been the first time that the public was seeing this, but for months there had been lots of different issues brewing inside the company. So, you know, you had this sexual harassment payout, $90 million to Andy Rubin. Mm-hmm. That was sort of the spark for the walkout. You'd also had these business decisions that Google had made kind of in secret.
Two of the projects that come up again and again in this story are Project Maven and Dragonfly. Can you walk us through what both of those are?
Sure. So Dragonfly is a search engine project that Google was working on for China, and it was basically censored search. And Google had pulled out of China in 2010, its search engine, basically for human rights reasons. And so when employees found out that the company was working on a censored search engine again for China, I think that was one of the reasons that they were particularly upset. Project Maven is a contract with the Pentagon by which the Pentagon was using Google's AI to look at drone footage and scan drone footage. And employees were really concerned that technology, that Google technology, could be used down the chain to make drone strikes more lethal. So again, really did not want Google engaged in any sort of warfare activity. Employees were saying, this is not okay, and we're doing it very vocally. And so management, I think, is really trying to figure out how can we keep the culture we've had of debate alive as we are now a 100,000 employee company.
Where do you think, I mean, we've talked about this being fast moving and it's nowhere near resolved at Google. Where do you think the company goes from here?
That's a really good question. I mean, I've asked them that. I should say that Google has known I've been working on this story since the beginning. I've talked to a couple people that they sort of put forward for me to talk to, particularly on the culture side. They're pretty honest that this is something that they're working on right now, that they don't have all the answers, that they're not sure how to handle all this. And I think, you know, they are trying to talk to employees. They do lots of surveys. You know, they're very data driven, so they're trying to actually take the real temperature of how employees feel. I think they don't know.
Yeah, and how do you fix something that's so amorphous in some ways? You know, it's a much more subtle and difficult thing to fix than this product isn't doing what it's supposed to do. So I think it's a real test of a company in that sense.
I have seen friends get hurt and, well, have their careers destroyed by this, not just at Google, but everywhere, including all forms of tech.
I think your social responsibility is really important this time for tech companies.
We've always been a vanguard company, so if we don't lead the way, nobody else will.
So how do you approach a story like this, where what you really need is voices from inside the company that can talk to you about, you know, what they're doing and what they're seeing? And I mean, we certainly know that's not an easy thing.
Yeah, I spent a lot of time talking to people. I think it was not a story where you could just call someone, have a 15-minute conversation, and that was it. I talked to people multiple times, really lengthy, you know, multiple hour conversations. I met with a lot of people in person, which I think really helps. And, you know, I'm not a tech reporter, and so I think I did have to build that trust. But I also think that coming from outside the tech industry gave me a perspective that was helpful.
Mm-hmm. You actually told me something that sticks out for me, which is that in all your years of reporting, you have never worked on a story where so many current employees of the company would talk to you. And obviously, once people have left a company, a lot of times that frees them up. They feel like, you know, now they can say the things they never felt like they could say as employees. So what do you think that's about? Why do you think people that are currently employed at Google were willing to put themselves out there?
So I found that employees at Google were extremely well-educated about their rights as employees. I've never had anyone say protected concerted activity to me so many times as I have during this story.
And is that a labor organizing phrase?
Yeah, okay. So they were talking about their working conditions, and that's protected activity. And so a lot of people would talk to me about culture and workplace problems, but would not talk to me at all about the business. So they did draw pretty strict lines.
And this idea that, you know, using these phrases that have been used in sort of like labor law and labor organizing, you know, we haven't seen much of that in the tech industry. And that seems like a big part of this story, sort of a mental shift that some of the workers at Google and maybe more broadly in the industry are starting to think of themselves more as sort of that traditional idea of labor. Does that seem right?
Yeah. I didn't come up with this phrase. I don't want to take credit for it. But people will often say, you know, this is tech workers are realizing they're workers. And I think that they know that they have some privilege that other workers don't, and they're trying to use that. But they have grievances like everybody else. They are using these traditional methods of organizing, but what they're really asking for feels, I really think that's new.
So I'm curious how you think, you know, your story's about Google, and the particularities of Google and why this maybe could only be happening in the way it is happening at that company. But what do you see as sort of the larger takeaways of this story?
So I do think it is it's a story about scale and how you scale a culture and the challenges that come with that. And I do think that the rest of the tech world is watching. Right. We are seeing this now at Amazon, for example, was not a place where you were really publicly criticizing the company. That's changing. And I think I think employees are taking a little bit of a cue from Google.
Why did you think it was an important story to cover? What do you hope it will accomplish?
So, I think that one thing that we really try to do is take a step back and look at the bigger picture. And so there's been so much incremental news out of Google. I think we're really trying to look at what does this mean for this company at large? What does this say about Silicon Valley and tech? And also, what does it say about the changing relationship between workers and their employers? Silicon Valley is always on the edge. And I think because we're seeing this here first, we're going to see it elsewhere too. So I think the story has lessons that go far beyond Google too.
Yeah, I think that's right.